Standard 7th. Now we are coming to the next chapter, changes, physical and chemical. I have completed chapter number 12. Question answers I am giving you in the live class. So your this video sessions are only helping you to understand the chapter thoroughly. Whenever when we meet in live class, please if you have some questions, write it down so that you can ask me the questions and I can resolve your problems. Now this chapter is a very interesting chapter, as the word, the name of the chapter itself says, changes, physical and chemical. What does the word physical means and chemical? Physical changes which we can see, those which we can see, physical changes. For example, let us take example of oneself. Now when you were small in class 3rd, 4th, you are a small, tiny, sweet children. But now in class 7, you have become little taller, more beautiful, more healthier. That is called as physical change. A change is which can be seen. This is just, I am giving you the explanation. Not the scientific explanation, just for you all to understand the difference between physical and chemical. Chemical changes which we cannot see, but the chemical composition of the substance changes. That is called as chemical changes. I have made down some very easy concept map, because in this chapter you just need to know the terminology. So let us first come up to the two main important changes, natural and man-made. As the word natural speaks, the changes which occurs naturally. I have given you one example over your ripening of fruit. There are many natural changes which are occurring simultaneously. Okay, now apart from that, rusting of iron, natural change. Raindrops falling down, that is also a natural change. Man-made changes. What is man-made changes? You bring vegetables which are natural, but you cut them according to your desire, shape and size. That is called as man-made changes. Apart from that, natural change is what? A tree and a leaf, but to go and cut the tree, that will be a man-made change. Other more examples, if electricity is not there, you go and switch on the bulb, light is there. Natural light is sun, man-made light is electricity or electric bulb which we light in our houses. So these are the two means. In this chapter, you only have to understand the terminologies, the concepts. So changes, there are different types, I have written down few. Some more are remaining, I'll be proceeding further. So natural and man-made, ripening of fruit, cutting of vegetables. In man-made, there are two, physical as well as chemical. As I'll be proceeding, I'm giving you one examples. A very self-study type chapter, you read the textbook, you don't understand anything, just line it down, underline it. When I meet you in my live session, please do ask me. Next two important change, I have made it in pairs. If you will see, I have made it in pairs. So it becomes easier for you all to understand. Second one, useful and harmful. Cooking of food is a useful change. Harmful, spoiling food. The food which is rotten and then you are eating, consuming it, it is a harmful change. Apart from that, sharpening a pencil, a useful change, because you need to write it down. Harmful change, rusting of iron. Rust is not good. The zung which is there in your bicycle, rusting of iron is not good. Let us proceed further. Fast and slow. Fast changes which occur for a short period of time, a fast change. Slow changes, long period of time. Aging is a slow process. Okay. Aging is a slow process. It takes time to gray your hair. Now your hair is black. But to gray your hair, or to your hair to turn gray, it will take some time. So it's a slow process. Fast, you know. I'll give you a very easy example. You are coming to school and this you know the school bell will go within 5 minutes. So what will be the fast change? You will start running to reach the school. And slow, if you know there is half an hour more for the bell to go. So you will walk slowly, slowly. So that will be called as a slow change. Okay. Next one, reversible, irreversible. Very important. The word reversible means forward and backward. You convert it into the main compound and again you bring back into its original place is called as a reversible change. Irreversible change, it will only move forward, it will not come backward. These are different types of changes which you are going to learn. Apart from there, there are other more changes which we are going to learn. So reversible, irreversible, forward and backward. You can, now, if you have a raw mango, and it becomes ripe, can you again bring it back to its original place? No. So, it's an irreversible changes. And reversible changes, it can be ice, you take water, you transform it into ice. And again, you melt back, it will become ice. Okay, so water to ice and ice to water is a reversible change. You take sugar syrup and you melt it. It becomes air. You take sugar crystals and you melt it. It becomes sugar syrup. Again, you cannot bring sugar to back into the crystallization form. These are various examples. These are various terms which are used to show different types of changes. Apart from that, there are other two more important changes, which is called as periodic change and non-periodic change. Periodic change, it will take upon a certain definite interval of time. That is called as periodic change. And non-periodic change will not take at a particular definite interval of time. Now, as an activity, I am giving you this. Can you see this in your textbook? I want you all to fill up and keep it ready. When I have my life class, I will be asking you, here it is written, what changes have taken place in the material seen in the following picture? What kind of changes are they? So I want you all, in my live video, I'm telling you all, you will write it and keep. Now what is this? Milk. This is ice is melting. This seed is developing into a shoot. Water is boiling. Fire is cracking. This is crackers and this is fire is burning and again crackers. I want you all to tell me whether it is which type of change. You can give me any example whether it is natural, man-made, reversible, irreversible, but it should be appropriate to this picture, relevant. It should be relevant to the picture. Now you cannot say, now this ice is melting. And again, it will come back to the ice form. It can be a reversible change. This cannot be a reversible change. It can be a reversible change. So, or you can say man-made. This is man-made change because you can prepare firecrackers and lit them. This is a man-made change. Water boiling into steam. This is a natural change. So, I just want you to classify and keep it ready whether it is a which type of changes I said. On the second part, here in the chapter, I have here given one this. Which of the following changes shown in the picture alongside are temporary or permanent? I want you all to do this both as an activity. In my life class, I'll be asking you all to tell me whether it is a temporary change or a permanent change. I can give you now, this is a temporary change. Ice is forming water, water can form ice. So temporary change. Raw mango becomes ripe mango. Now ripe mango cannot come back to raw mango. So it is a permanent change. So this is what it is there in this chapter. Only the terminologies. You just have to understand the terminology. Whatever question answers are there in my live sessions, I'll be giving it to you. Okay? Thank you.